my dad became infamous. He was the first like West Indian civil court judge they had in New York. So
impressive.
He did not retire a judge. Dad, I love you, but I can tell the story because it was all in the papers. He got caught up in some stuff. Yeah, he got caught
up in clutch my pearls. Hold on for a second. Go ahead.
Yeah, he got caught up in some stuff.
What stuff?
I don't know. To this day, I'm not sure what it was about. Something taking money out of an escrow account. They kind of hid it from us when we were kids because it was all in the papers and on the TVs.
So he did the ghost and Tyreek.
I guess something like that.
he didn't keep it funky.
Some kind of scheme. I don't know what it was, but he got caught and it was all in the papers. It was around the time all those judges were getting caught for corruption. So he got caught up in that. And he lost his job pretty much.
Oh, no, daddy.
Then he had some issues with his second baby mother and,
infidelity.
It just kind of went that way. I love him to death now. You forgive him.
He said now.
It was rough, man. I did not want to talk to him for a while.
Right.
He had people calling the house like, yo, how do you feel about your father? Don't do this. It was on TV. It was on the Post. So I was on TV before I was on TV.
Right.
You know what
I'm
saying? But it's all good now. He's in Georgia now. He's living his best life.
He got another family?
Nah, I don't think he wants to get married again. I think he just wants to, kind of enjoy his, retirement time.
Interesting. Yeah. That's very interesting. Yeah. Any siblings?
I have two sisters. I got a twin sister.
Shout out Identical?
Nah.
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
I mean, one ugly girl.
Good night. Good night.
Girl, what happens to your edges? Ew, that's your twin. Oh god, where are his edges at? I'm just kidding.
You're so stupid.
Nah, it's my twin sister. She's 8 minutes older than me, and then I got an older sister. I think she's a couple of years. She's 43 or 44. I don't know.
You're the baby.
Yeah, I'm the baby. I was technically the baby. My mother's favorite.
Big baby too.
Yes, late bloomer. I didn't get to height until sophomore year in high school, and then I didn't get the size until college.
Interesting.
I was the shortest one in my family.
Really?
My mother's 5'8". So I was
How tall is daddy?
Dad's 6'1", 6'1", 6'2", but I was 5'6". Until sophomore year. So we got pictures of us in Christmas photos. I'm just sitting there looking like, I look up to you, Mom. Just looking like Shrimp B.
What kind of student were you?
I was a terrible student.
Really?
Yeah, I was terrible at math. All the stuff that could make you money in life, I was terrible at it. Math, science, gym. I was bad at gym.
How can you be bad at gym?
Because
all you got to do is show up and bring your uniform.
Yeah, but they would have these physical fitness tests, and I wasn't physical nor fit. So it was bad. You'd have to do pull-ups and couldn't do the pull-ups. And
not one pull-up?
Nah, it was bad. It was bad. My boy back here laughing at me, but you couldn't do a pull-up either, Rob. All right? You couldn't do a pull-up either.
Rob, shut up!
You had to do, how many, I don't remember. You don't remember they used to have it was they had a physical fitness test and they would train you the whole time and I would fail. I was bad at sports, man. Basketball was okay, but everything else I just wasn't good.
I played basketball in school.
Yeah, me too.
I was very short.
I only got
you
good.
You heard me? Was.
I only got good because I got tall and it was easier to dominate. But when I was younger, it was trash. So I was bad at all subjects except for history.
So did you play basketball or?
I did. I did play for a little bit. Again, like I said, I wasn't good, so I just kind of gave up.
Mm-hmm.
No shade.
Any instrument?
I played the tenor sax in high school. Yeah, I played the tenor saxophone. I played the oboe, and for
the
a very
oboe.
Short time. That was my mother. That's the mother. You know, your parents went, you play something fancy with a fancy sounding. Play the oboe. I don't play the sax.
Were you any good?
Oboe. Yeah, I was all right. I didn't like the oboe too much because it's little parts and I had big fingers. So I preferred the sax. And then I played the bass guitar for a year when I was in junior high school.
Oh.
Yeah, I was the one to creative stuff. Art, I was good at art. Mm-hmm. All right, I was good at writing. I was good in English, history class.
Well, that's a subject that you can use in your life to make money.
Really? They didn't tell me how.
They
didn't tell me how. What am I going to do with learning the difference between a verb and a syllable and a consonant?
It's very important. Look at Instagram. It's ridiculous.
Spelling is bad on Instagram. Spelling is bad. You're
ridiculous.
Right. Pay attention in class, kids.
Yeah, come on. You guys
no mistakes.
Not looking good. So aside from enterprise...
Mm-hmm.
Any other jobs?
I used to work at Best Buy, right in Brooklyn at Bay Plaza. Was it Bay Plaza?
How long you worked there?
I was there for 2 years. I hated it.
Is there any place that you've worked where I could get a hookup?
You looking for the hookup?
I don't care if it's a McDonald's.
I never worked at McDonald's. I worked at Pizza and Uno for like two days.
How do you work at Enterprise for 7 years and don't have somebody there just still like, yo, if I need this?
Because like all the people I work with left the company. That's how you know the company. It's all right when you first coming out of school, but just long term, I saw a glass ceiling. I didn't see a lot of diversity. And I was just like, you know what? I don't see nobody look like me in the top. And it's just not going to. I put on my most weight when I worked that job. That's something was the worst job I ever had.
So that means you did nothing.
No, I sat around all day. You know what I mean? I met some great people, but the company was just like, oh my God, like you can't do this, man.
What about college? Any college?
Yeah, I went to University of Albany. Graduated there about 5 years. Yeah, I graduated 5 years. Yeah, I got a little bit of thing. I can't tell you what I learned, but
good night. Listen, kids, turn this off right now.
I got a degree that I hang up on my wall. I think my mother has it. We paid for it. It costs us about $30,000, but it's worth it. Hey. It's worth it.
But, you know, it's funny that you said that your mother has hanging up. I was just curious to know, mm-hmm. how does your parents feel or about supporting you with the acting thing? So, like, are they big on education or are they your dreams type?
A little of both. So, you know, I told you they're both West Indian. So, right. like, for my mother, especially, education was paramount. I knew from when I was in elementary school that she was like, no, you go to elementary, you go to junior high, you go to high school, and you go to college. There was no question.
Period.
There was no, like, nah, I'm going to go in the military. Nah. Elementary.
That's right.
I knew I was going to college from when I was in the second grade. Mm-hmm. So it was very important for her to do that. She was not happy to hear that I was planning on leaving the job that I had, but I was miserable. I was miserable. Like, every day I would come in there, I was putting on weight. I dreaded going into mm-hmm. work. You know what I mean? So, like, I told her I was going to leave. Well, what are you going to do? I said, I think I'm going to go back into radio, because there was a time when I was going to do radio. I had done radio at Albany. I was very successful at Radio Albany. I told you I was DJing, so mm-hmm. I was still doing it. I was like, yeah, I'm going back into radio and do that. And it didn't happen like that. So, you know, I'd saved up my money and, you know, gotten stand-up comedy. Then
we're going to get to that one.
I didn't get to that point yet. All right. I tend to be long-winded. I apologize.
And wait a minute. So you saying all of this about stand-up comedy and you're tired of your job. What is mommy saying? Like,
this is blue collar West Indian. Yo, don't quit your job.
That's a good job.
You know, you got, you know, you got married, you got your wife, you got responsibilities. You can't just leave. I was like, your mom,
but
not
you
happy.
Explained that there was no advancement for you, right?
She didn't care. My mother, let me tell you something. My mother,
you go to work.
Yeah, exactly. Right, she didn't like her job, but she did it because she had us. 35 years at night shift. That's not easy.
It ain't.
You know what I mean? So
it ain't.
She was like, look, you get a job. You got a 401k. What are you doing?
Right,
like,
right.
Don't quit. That was her attitude. Don't. I support you in anything you do, but this is dumb.
I feel you.
This isn't going nowhere. Mm-hmm. Don't quit.
As a kid, were you a big TV watcher?
That's all we had. We didn't have cable. I love my mother to death, but I realized she was lying when she told us. She's like, they don't have cable in our area. She's like, I'm like, everybody had cable, and you know, we couldn't afford it. She's like, yeah, they don't have it here yet. All right, we can't get cable. We just, you know, we got the TV with the hangers, the antenna, put some foil around it.
You had Video Music Box.
I did watch, but that's when we could get the UHF channels to turn. Because sometimes you get the pliers, it wouldn't work all the way. But yes, the box.
Right.
That was, we used to watch the box for hours. Not Video Music Box, the box.
Okay.
The old school, people would know, you used to call up a number, you had to pay like 69 cents.
Good night.
And you could, it was $1.69, and you could get whatever video played on it that you wanted. That was what we watched. That, the box, and the Spanish channels, because it was entertaining. I know what they were saying. It was just funny to watch him. Let me out. I don't know what he's talking about. He's going to spin that wheel. This is fascinating. He's going to spin that wheel again. I just like watching them dance. It was, I don't know. You ain't have nothing as a kid, so it was just like, we thought that was entertaining.